Hi friends, so today I'm going to explain you about importance or significance or role of chemistry in engineering. That is, why chemistry is needed in engineering or for engineering students. After entering into the engineering, in the very first year, you're going to have the chemistry. By seeing the chemistry, something will be pondering in your mind that why again chemistry, right? Because a lot of chemical reactions, typical chemical reactions would be a part of the chemistry, right? And since your childhood, you have studied, you have learned those chemical reactions, typical chemical reactions, and it is not that easy to remember all those chemical reactions. Again, the same story, right? So, this sort of hatredness you will create on the chemistry, right? But my dear students, I want to make you to get rid of the illusions you are, because being a technical students, technological students, you will be under impression that why chemistry. So before I explain why chemistry, let me explain about the importance of science actually, because chemistry is a part of the science. So you'll be thinking that being a technological students or technology students, why the science is there in the engineering again and again. So my dear students, please come out from the illusion that engineering is all about the combination of science and technology. It is not itself the technology, right? It is a combination of science and technology. And it is believed that today's science is the technology of tomorrow. And both are inevitable. That is, both science and technology are inseparable. One depends upon the other. That science depends upon the technology and technology depends upon the science. First, come out from this illusion that being a technological student or technology student, science is not needed for me. Please come out from this. Because your engineering is the combination of science and technology. It is not all just about the technology itself. I hope you understood till now. Right. Now, to discuss, to be more precise, we have to discuss the importance of our role of the chemistry in engineering. Right? Let's start. So, before going to enter into the details, let me ask you one question: that what is that substance which is being used by each and every engineer, irrespective of the branch? Just give you a pause to the video, think of it, and get back to the video. That particular substance which is being used or utilized by each and every engineer, irrespective of the branch, is nothing but the metal. Let's take aeronautical engineer. Aeronautical engineer is supposed to design the aircraft parts for which he need duralumin, which is the alloy of aluminium, metal. Combination of the metals is nothing but the alloy. Right. Let's take civil engineer. Civil engineer is the one who is going to plan the construction and ensures the quality of the construction material. And the most important construction material by any of the civil engineer is iron metal. Likewise, let's take EC, electronics and communication engineering. If you open any of the electronic item or electronic good or gadgets, so you can find n number of metals on it, and each and every metal is having its own significance. Similarly, triple E, right? Electrical engineering students, without the copper metal, it is not possible, right? Electrical engineering, imagination, it is beyond the imagination. Similarly, mechanical engineering, right? Mechanical engineer will deal with the machines, and all the machines are going to be designed with the help of one or the other metal. Right. So here, okay, this is about the aeronautical engineering, mechanical engineering, ECE, EEE and all that stuff, but the CSC people, IT and allied branched people, that is whatever the branches which are very much correlated to the computer science and engineering students, will be a huge illusion that the science is not at all needed, because being a software student, what the hell to do with the science? It's not so. You'll be under this impression. Why the science is needed? Because being a software, you are supposed to develop any sort of software, encoding, decoding, and all the stuff. It is overdone. The game is done. Why the science is needed? Why the chemistry is needed? Why the mathematics? Why the physics is needed? My dear students, I want to make you very clear that try to open the computer. If you open the computer, you can find more than 20 metals in it. More than 20 metals in it, right? Like copper is a part of it, nickel is a part of it, gold is a part of it, palladium is a part of it, right? Tantalum is a part of it. There are so many metals are there, right? So by chance or by choice, if you are supposed to join as a hardware, that is totally different story. If at all you get the choice of designing the computers, making use of all these metals, so how can you manage it? Designing the computers is not that simple responsibility, right? It's not the simple responsibility. It is being given to the people who are well-versed with all the knowledge of all the components which are used to design a computer. So if such sort of opportunity is given to you, what you will do? You do nothing, right? Because you don't know the knowledge of the material which is being used. You don't know the knowledge of the properties of the materials which are being used for designing a computer. So my dear students, what I mean to say is, without the knowledge of the metals, without the knowledge of the materials, without the knowledge of the properties related to the metals and the materials, you might become an engineer, no doubt in that, but you might not become, you will not become a perfect engineer. Perfect engineer is only possible when you are perfectly equipped with the scientific knowledge along with the technological knowledge. This is what missing. So because of the lack of all the scientific knowledge, what you are doing, just you are behaving like a sheep in the flock of sheep. For example, if X is utilizing one particular material, by seeing the X, you will follow the X, the Y will follow the X, the Z will follow the X, because we are a flock of sheep, right? We are sheep in a flock of sheep. We are not thinking innovatively. We are not creating anything. We are not thinking beyond our limit. This is what's happening. Why? Because this is due to the lack of knowledge related to the properties of the metals and the materials which are going to be used for your engineering good. It is not being confined to, I'm not talking about the computer science and related branches. It is applicable for each and every one of you. If one is using that particular material, you are using the same thing, because the reason is, what is the reason for it? Because you don't know the complete knowledge on the properties of the new material, initially the old existing material. If you don't know the knowledge or the properties, knowledge of properties of the metal or the material which is being used, existing, I was saying, right? Then how you can innovate the things, how you can create the things, because the creativity comes with the existence knowledge. And you are not grabbing the existing knowledge, then how your creativity thinking is improved? It is not at all possible, right? For example, to be more precise, let's take any of the branded mobile. Just open any of the branded mobile, whether it's a top brand mobile, let's say the Apple mobile or the China mobile, whatever it is. 1 lakh mobile to 1,000 mobile. Just open it. You can find only one type of battery in it. What is that? A lithium-ion battery. Have you ever thought that why only lithium-ion battery? Right. At least have you made an attempt that why only lithium-ion battery is a part of each and every branded mobile, irrespective of its cost, irrespective of its nature and everything? You're least bothered, right? You are just bothered about the following. If one is following that, I will follow that. If lithium is doing the job of a battery, why not the sodium does the same job? Because lithium and sodium belongs to the first eight group elements. When one of the metal is doing the job of a battery, why can't the metal which has the close relation in the properties can do the job? You never think of it. This is what happening. So you don't know the knowledge about the properties of the metals and the materials which are being used by you in order to design the engineering good or engineering item after you are engineering. This is what happening. So my dear students, once again I'm saying that without the knowledge of the science, without the knowledge of the chemistry, you might become an engineer, but you cannot become a perfect engineer, right? I already have said that why the chemistry is needed here, that just now I said that the knowledge of the properties of the materials or the metals is required here. And that knowledge about the properties of the metals and materials is going to be provided by the science behind all these metals and the materials. And that particular science behind these materials and metals is nothing but the chemistry. So this is the reason you need to study the chemistry. It doesn't mean that chemistry involves a lot of chemical reactions, typical chemical reactions. And we are not going to use those chemical reactions elsewhere. Please don't think that. Even though a lot of typical chemical reactions are a part of the chemistry, each and every chemical reaction, each and every topic which is a part of chemistry is having its own significance. Right? Okay, it is having its own significance. You have to. And there is a concept behind each and every topic. I try to understand the concept. So don't mug up the chemical reaction, don't mug up the concept, don't mug up the properties and all that stuff. Try to understand the concept behind each and every metal and the material is going to be used for you. Right. Now, in order to explain the importance of chemistry in your engineering, I will consider the JEE to Hyderabad syllabus as a reference. Right. And as I am considering the JEE to Hyderabad syllabus as a reference, doesn't mean that this particular video is confined only to the JEE to Hyderabad students, because more or less the syllabus which is a part of the JEE to Hyderabad is similar to other universities as well. The first unit is battery chemistry. So in this battery chemistry, you are going to learn about how the battery can be designed with the concept of electrochemical cell, and the battery is the very, very important engineering good or engineering item which is going to be used by you, and that you the people are going to design this battery. And for designing the battery, the first unit helps you. In this particular unit, you are going to learn about the existing batteries, properties of the existing batteries. Based upon the properties of the existing batteries, you will become capable of designing the new batteries with new technology. Coming to the second unit, in the second unit, you're going to study how the metals are being damaged with the corrosion phenomena. Corrosion is nothing but gradual destruction or deterioration of a metal due to unwanted chemical or electrochemical interaction with its environment. And corrosion process damages the metal. And this particular knowledge of corrosion is very important, because by this particular corrosion unit, you'll get the knowledge or information about under what conditions the corrosion is, or under what conditions the metals or materials are damaged easily. And what is that metal and the material is being damaged easily, so that you'll never utilize that particular metal for designing your engineering good or item. Moreover, with the help of this second unit, you will become capable of nullifying or reducing the damage of the metal which is going to be utilized by you for designing your engineering good or an item. This is our second unit. And coming to the third unit is the polymers. How much significance is associated with the conductors in the engineering, the same significance is associated with the insulators, because without the insulators, conductor is not possible, because the plastic portion, which is a part of the metallic wire, is very, very important. Otherwise, you'll get the shock, right? And these polymers about which you are going to study in this particular third unit has the excellent insulating properties. And these excellent insulating properties, so you are going to study in this particular unit. You are going to study about the properties of almost each and every very important polymers. Moreover, you are going to learn about the biodegradable polymers, and these biodegradable polymers are the future polymers, because these biodegradable polymers are the one which undergo degradation by the action of the microorganism in the presence of the sunlight, and these are eco-friendly. Furthermore, the polymers are indispensable in our regular life. Without the polythene cover, nowadays we cannot imagine our lives. So all this stuff you are going to learn in the third unit. Now coming to the fourth unit, green chemistry. And green chemistry is nothing but the chemistry which is eco-friendly, is nothing but the green chemistry, right? And after learning this green chemistry, you will become capable of designing the chemical reaction which is eco-friendly in nature. Moreover, you can avoid the fire hazards as well. Let's say the Bhopal gas tragedy, right? Bhopal gas tragedy is due to the leakage of methyl isocyanide. It is utterly or literally, it is engineering skills, lack of engineering skills, lack of engineering skills. So because of lack of engineering skills by the supervisor who's a part of that particular Bhopal gas leakage, that particular leakage had happened, right? So in this particular unit, you learn how to avoid how to stop the leakage problems, and how to avoid all this nonsense stuff or all this fire accidents, right? So coming to the last unit, in the last unit, you're going to learn about the smart materials, and the smart materials are very, very important, right? Important engineering materials. So I'm not going to enter into the details, right? Engineering materials. And not only that, in this particular unit, you are going to study about the biodiesel, which is very eco-friendly diesel, and it is the revolutionary diesel, and it is going to be our future diesel. No doubt in that. Right? So, with the help of these five units, I tried to explain how the chemistry is significant or important in the engineering. Right? My dear students, as I discussed earlier, that your engineering is the combination of the science and technology. It is not just about the technology, right? And as I discussed, based upon the argument, it's very clear that for becoming the perfect engineer, you need the knowledge about the properties of each and every metal and the material which is going to be used by you for designing the electronic or whatever the engineering good or item is. For which you need to learn the science behind the properties of the metals and materials which are going to be used in the engineering. And that particular science behind the metals and the materials which we are going to use in your engineering is nothing but the chemistry. So this is the reason the chemistry is a part of engineering. But don't be in an illusion that chemistry is not required in the engineering. It is a must in engineering. So in order to become a perfect engineer, I hope you understood this particular video, right? So thanks for watching. And one more thing is, please don't create hatred on any of the subjects, whether it is science or technology, whatever it is, because each and every subject is having its own significance. Try to understand the significance of each and every subject before going to enter into that particular subject. Try to understand the significance of each and every topic which is a part of that particular subject. So try to create interest. So accordingly, you can perform well in your exams. So thanks for watching.